someone ask about the tree of life, and why was it most likely an almond tree, and where can we find any proof for that? Okay, there's not any emphatic, absolutely nailed down scripture that says that the tree of life found in the garden was an almond tree, but there are very, very strong allusions to it. All right, two off the top of my head are: number one, is the rod that budded of Aaron's rod. Okay, it budded what? It was an almond tree. What did the staff represent? It was the authority of God. It was a representation of the truth found on earth in its most powerful form, was the almond tree. That was the absolute authority, the symbol of authority was that almond tree. Because when it budded, bam, everybody else's was out of the deal. This was the authority club, was the one who held that staff. And number two, in my opinion, even as or more powerful proof that the tree of life was an almond tree, was that the menorah that stood in the temple was called the tree of life, okay? And the menorah in Judaism, they called it the tree of life as far back as you can go. And the menorah is made up of almonds and its blossoms, okay, on every branch. God said to make it a gold piece out of almond and their blossoms and the buds. And so the idea and the illusion that the very tree of life that is giving light, that represents the word of God, that represents the authority, that represents the truth, is the almond. He chose the almond tree. And you go back to the Garden of Eden, and the tree of life represents the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth, the authority of God, the very presence of God, the sword of God, the spirit of God is represented by that. And then he chooses in these areas to use the almond tree out of every other tree. It is the deduction of virtually all of Judaism, and scholars will say that the tree of life most likely was an almond tree.
If you were blessed by this teaching, please consider helping us reach the nations by making a donation today. Thank you, and God bless.